So our next speaker is Ayrat Khalimov, and he's going to answer the question that was just asked, how to do LTL bounded synthesis for acceptance conditions beyond Buki.
Thank you for introduction. And back to this question about other acceptance conditions. We have tried this, but we get stuck usually in the translation from LTL to Rabin automata. Already at this step, it's too expensive. OK, let's talk about extending acceptance conditions and also about different logic, branching logic, CTL star. Let's start with what is LTL synthesis problem. In LTL synthesis problem, we are given LTL formula and separation of signals into inputs and outputs. And we want to find a system, which is usually finite state system, that satisfies the formula, or otherwise, if it's not possible, return unrealizable. And there is one very nice approach, bounded approach to LTL synthesis by Sven Scheve and Bernd Finkbeiner, and this looks It works like this. It starts with LTL formula phi, it translates, then it, why is it called bounded? It fixes a size on the system, then it searches a system of this size, and there are two outcomes. If not found, then if found, we get a system of this size. If not found, we check if there is a limit, some limit reached, and there is a theoretical bound on the limit. And if yes, unrealizable. If not, we increase the bound, and we continue. And in this, this box is the most important part, is a search of how to find a system of size k. This is bounded synthesizer. And in this talk, we are going to talk about how to extend this particular box. And if you look into this box, how it looks like inside, so there is LTL formula phi, system size. And what happens in the first step, we translate LTL formula into so-called universal Kabuki word automata. And then we take this word automata and the system size, and we encode them into SMT query. And the SMT query looks like this. It says, is there a transition function of our system? This is uninterpreted function tau. Is there output labeling for the system? It's also uninterpreted function. And then there is some SMT query, which essentially is satisfiable if and only if the system encoded by these two uninterpreted functions, tau and output, all executions of the system are accepted by this automaton. So if you look, if it's unsatisfiable, then we say, no, it's unrealizable for this particular size. And if it's satisfiable, we return a system of size k. And what are our results in this paper? It was known already how to encode into SMT query the question how if the system of size k satisfies if all executions of our system satisfy the Kabuki or Buchi condition, or is there exist a path which satisfies Kabuki and Buchi condition. And in this paper we introduced new encodings for whether the system satisfies street acceptance conditions and Rabin acceptance condition. And street encoding is new, and Rabin is based on the other work. And we also extended it to branching time logics. Now, in two lines, it's a first bounded synthesizer for the conjunctions of all these acceptance conditions and also for CTL star logic. You may ask why you want to consider street, Rabin, and CTL star. As for street Rabin automata, as was already asked before, street and Rabin automata, they can be smaller for some particular properties. And we can benefit from smaller automata. As for CTL star, it's very well known properties. Very well known fact that in LTL you cannot express a property like resetability, which says on all paths there is always a way to reach some particular state, some reset state. And also, there is another reason why to consider it. It's for so-called vacuity checking. If you don't know what is vacuity checking, just ignore it. If you know, then you know it. Okay, so we can actually focus, forget about synthesis and focus on model checking at this point. And this is because if you look into this particular SMT query that we always ask SMT solver, it looks like this. Is there some transition function, just some uninterpreted function? Is there some uninterpreted function for outputs such that some particular SMT query, some these assertions are satisfied? But if you look at this carefully, the first, this quantifier prefix, essentially it says, fix a system, and then check that this system is actually correct. So this is just a model checking query if you remove this quantifier prefix. And that's why we can focus on model checking in the rest of the talk. And if you're interested how you actually encode this into SMT query, then it looks like this. Initially, you declare what will how large will be your system, and this is just a way to declare finite enumeration type. There are two states, a zero is one. Then we introduce uninterpreted function, which is defined on states, and it accepts some inputs. In this particular case, it accepts one input and provides the next state. And for output, the same thing. It labels states with some Boolean signals, with outputs. And the query is this one. It looks like there is the query talks about this uninterpreted function. Yeah, actually, this is not G0, G1. It's just one output function, and it encodes this acceptance condition. OK. Now let's recall what is Kobuchian street automata. And it's just it has some alphabets, a set of states, initial state, some transition function, and acceptance conditions. And this is what is interesting for Kobuchi acceptance. We require that every path, that a path is accepted if it doesn't visit a state from this set infinitely often. So we avoid visiting the state infinitely often. And for street acceptance, essentially we have pairs, and we say that path is accepted if for every pair, if you visit this infinitely often, then you have to visit this infinitely often. Okay, now let's actually look how this encoding looks like. And this is the standard approach is you take your system, you take your automaton, you build the product, and then you search in this product for some cycles. And imagine this is a product, and in this product some states may be like bad states or states which belong to this acceptance set of the Kobuchi automaton. And in this particular case, there is a bad cycle. And we can encode this problem of searching of bad cycles into SMT query. And how we do this, we introduce rank, which is just the numbers for every state. And this state, and we introduce additional rules. And the rules look like this. So if we exit a normal state, white state in this picture, then we just non-strictly decrease the number. And if we exit red state or bad state, we strictly decrease. Now let's look into this. Is there a ranking numbering for this particular product? And there should be none. So first we require that there should be less or equal because this is a normal state. Also less or equal, also less or equal. At this point, we exit the acceptance state. We require it should be strictly less. And here, less or equal. And now, obviously, then, if we start trying to number it, for example, we start with 5, 5, 5, and here we have 4. And at this particular point, we cannot satisfy these constraints. It's unsatisfiable. Now, this we can encode this kind of constraints into SMT query. In this particular case, these constraints will be unsatisfiable if we require that all paths in the product satisfy these constraints. Now, what happens if we are not interested in all paths of the system? What if we are interested in one path in the system which satisfies these constraints? In this particular case, we can go into the right cycle and we can assign 5, 5, 5, 5, and everything is okay. And this shows that it's satisfiable if you look for one path. So now, an interesting part: how do you do new rank? How do you do this for street? And imagine we have just one street pair, and it's very simple. We introduce also just one number for every state, but the rules are slightly different. As before, when we exit normal state, we non-strictly decrease. When we exit this red state, we strictly decrease, and when we exit green state, we reset. So what does it mean? As before, less or equal, less or equal, less or equal. Okay, here it's less, and at this point it's reset. What does it mean, reset? It means that we do not relate these two numbers. And now, if we want to assign numbers, we can find numbers, for example, if we are searching just for one path, which is accepting, then we can assign 5, 5, 5, and everything is satisfied. Okay, this was about, we know how to do for all paths, and we know how to do for exist paths. And we can actually conjoin them. What if you have combination, conjunction? And it's quite easy. If you have something like this, then essentially we can build this empty query for this part, and join it together and solve one big SMT query. Okay, but what happens if you have nested exist and for all quantifiers? It's about CTL star, how to encode it. And let's consider this particular system. It has initial state on the left. There is no grant. On the right state, there is grant. If you receive request, you go to the right. If you don't receive request, you go to the left. And we're asking a question, does this system satisfy this property or not? This is CTL star property. It says on all paths, there is always, it's always the case that there exists a path where eventually, globally, you never grant. And it's, if you're familiar with CTL star, then for you, it's quite obvious that this system satisfies because you can always go to the left state and stay there forever. Okay, now how we encode it into SMT? What we do, we introduce additional propositions, which are essentially outputs of the system, and for every subformula. So in this case, we introduce additional proposition P, and then we encode that, then we fold the system, fold the property using this proposition, and encode whether the system satisfies on all paths, it's always the case that PE holds. And we know how to do this using the previous encodings. Now, it's not enough. Whenever a state is marked with P, we need to ensure that it actually satisfies the property which is encoded by this proposition. And so we additionally add this constraint whenever a state is mapped, labeled with this PE, it implies that this system starting from this state satisfy this property. And again, we already know how to do all these subparts. We know how to do this part, and we know how to do AEG. Eventually, the property looks like this. So there is some uninterpreted function, transition function, uninterpreted function for output. There are uninterpreted functions for these propositions that we introduce. And then there is a query which looks like system satisfies top-level formula. We know how to do this using known encodings, and there is on the bottom from every state, if a state is labeled with PE, it implies that, and we know how to do this part already. Okay, this brings me to conclusion, and the conclusion is, okay, in this paper we described how to do bounded synthesis for the conjunctions of all these acceptance conditions and CTL star properties. We also implemented this approach in the tool. You can download the tool and try it out. In this presentation, I mentioned only one way of doing CTL star encoding in the tool. There are two other ways. Another way is using so-called alternating hesitant tree automata. Okay, and future directions could be how to check unrealizability. And if you're interested, we can check synth paper. And extend this branching logic to so multi-agent logics like ATL. And finally, question of efficiency. It's not very efficient. How to encode it into safety games and use BDDs. Thank you. And if,
So we have time for several questions.
Yeah.
Could you elaborate a little bit on the other technique you mentioned for doing CTL star synthesis?
So the technique that I presented here, essentially it follows a standard bottom-up model checker approach when you label states with subformulas. Another technique is using its automata theoretic approach by Vardy and Kupferman. And it's essentially what you can turn CTL star property into so-called alternating hesitant tree automaton. And once you turn this into this hesitant automaton, you can just use the same approach as for LTL properties. You take this automaton, you build the product, and you check whether there are cycles. And this is, in contrast to what I presented here, this approach has a very simple encoding. Once you build this product, it's very easy. Yeah, but we have tried, and it's not so fast, but yeah. And it's not so fast because it's just not very well implemented. Yep.
Okay, thanks. Any more questions?
So you mentioned that you could benefit from smaller automata if you use Rabino's treat. Do you have examples where synthesis is more efficient because of that?
This is a very good question, and I think I tried to answer it before, and the answer is if you take the standard problems from syncom competition, for example, and encode it, try to use a Rabinizer, then it just cannot handle it at all. But for easy properties, we haven't tried.
Let's thank Aira again.